Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. On the agenda tonight, we're going all the way back to the European Blues Festival of 1963. We're going to be taking a listen to Matt Guitar Murphy, and he's also going to be joined by Billy Stepney on drums and Memphis Slim on piano. So let's get the guys up on screen and see how they get on. Just 2 minutes and 50 in length, but there is so much in this performance. There are so many techniques that Matt goes through on the guitar. Obviously, he makes it look so easy that sometimes they fly under the radar. You don't notice them, but I'm going to be pointing them out for you. And just a quick mention of Memphis Slim on the piano as well. But the control that he has, just absolutely nailing the whole time. But also the lead runs with the right hand that he's playing on the piano. Such great lines, because they interact with the guitar so well. And everybody's absolutely in the groove here. And Billy Stepney is responsible for that swing and that groove that we get the whole way through. It's so easy to listen to this because of the quality of each instrumentalist. Just top players, just jamming out some classic blues and having so much jazz influence in there as well in Matt's playing. Some of the lines that he throws in there, those semitone rundowns and those chromatic sounding runs that he throws together, just give it such a cool jazz feel over the top of this classic blues progression. And I just want to point out the similarity in the intro between this and Johnny B. Goode, because it's a very similar rundown that we get. Chuck Berry was one of those guys that Matt recorded two albums with, so he knew him well. According to the records, Matt was on the scene, started recording 4 years before Chuck did, but I think it was a case that a lot of these blues players who were around at the same time watched each other, picked up each other's techniques, and really pushed each other on to become better players. And in the same year, 1963, Matt also played at the American Folk Blues Festival, and at that he played his track Matt's Guitar Boogie, and there's a lot of alternate picking in that video if you want to check that out as well. Super clean tone, exactly the same as this performance, definitely worth a watch. And that performance was also something that Freddie King has cited as an inspiration for his track called Hideaway, which I think was influenced by a lot of blues guitarists around at the time. And then Freddie King got into the studio and got down this track, which has now turned into a standard for countless blues musicians. And just when I'm talking about the alternate picking and the accuracy of the technique that's going on here, we've got some really cool slides as well that Matt throws in just to end phrases, and they're incidental slides in that you almost don't hear them, but they're definitely in there. They just sound so cool to use that as a throwaway line to end a phrase. And there's a lot of technique here that is subtle, but it is in there. And some of the phrases are so quick that you might miss some of the technique that's being put in there, because also at the time the frame rate of the cameras won't pick up the technique of the fingers because they're moving too quickly. But I want to draw your attention to something specifically. At 44 seconds we have a little run that Matt plays, and he repeats this run with a one note variation, and the one note that he's changing requires him to bar that third finger, so that when he's playing the riff after the one fret slide, he places his third finger on the B string and then flattens it down instantly to hear that high E string. It's so fast that you might miss it, especially seeing the technique in action, but you can hear that he nails it every time. And this tone being so clean, it means that if he didn't nail it, you'd hear it straight away. And having mentioned the clean tone that we've got here, Matt throws in a lot of alternate picking and a lot of picking in general, just to make sure that the notes pop out, because he hasn't got the luxury of sustain and distortion. So throwing in more picking means that he's getting that really clear, concise sound with his runs. And the only times that he does throw in hammer-ons and pull-offs are within faster runs and chromatic runs as well. And it gives such a great effect to be able to throw in the hammer-ons and the pull-offs, because then you'll get that different sound between the aggressiveness of the picks as well. These players were so great back in these times because they were forced to be great players, because if they weren't, they wouldn't be heard on the guitar. They'd lose the notes that they were playing. They'd be playing runs and nobody would be able to hear the runs because they haven't picked enough. And another thing I just want to draw your attention to in this performance, at 1 minute and 11 seconds, we've got a bend that Matt plays with his little finger, and it's just to indicate how organized Matt keeps his hand. Because when you're throwing together lines like Matt is during this performance, keeping the fingers organized is absolutely essential, especially playing jazz runs that might include a chromatic run. And when I say chromatic, I mean playing every note. Sometimes you'll have a run where you play a note with your little finger and then third finger, and then you'll have a tone jump to your first finger. And that means that you don't play the second finger, you miss out a note. Whereas chromatic means that you play every single note with every finger. So having them organized is absolutely essential to get these jazz runs together. Of course, Matt is so organized throughout this whole performance, and that's why he can throw together such quick chromatic phrases, but also keep them so accurate. Another thing you'll see Matt do is just dot in that vibrato to give that expression in his playing, but also to give that sound of control. Obviously, with the tone that he's got, there's not a hell of a lot of time that he can spend on a single note, because it is just going to decay to nothing straight away. But where he does hold on a note, he gets it to sing with that vibrato technique. Also, in 1948, when he was 19, he did start playing when he was a kid, and it was a young age to start playing professionally or with the big blues names, but he played with the Howlin' Wolf Band, and you can find Howlin' Wolf on this channel. not, if you want to check out his playing. He also has played with Buddy Guy and Otis Rush as well, and those two guys you can find on this channel as well. And at the time that he was playing with Howlin' Wolf, that was where Little Junior Parker was featured. So he certainly got out there early, and he did a lot of work with Memphis Slim in the late 50s and the 60s, as we can see from this video. And he recorded over six albums with James Cotton, the harmonica player. You might also recognize him from the Blues Brothers, because Dan Aykroyd and John Belushi went to watch him live and offered him a place in the touring band. He was also in the Blues Brothers film in 1980, and he also was in Blues Brothers 2000, which was in 1998, and he played the husband of Aretha Franklin in that movie. And he continued to perform with the Blues Brothers band all the way up until the early 2000s. That would have made him 70 years of age and above, so he really did play for his whole life. He was inducted into the Blues Hall of Fame in 2012, and unfortunately he passed away last year in 2018 at the age of 88. But we can take a look back at these videos and see what a fantastic player Matt was, the technical ability that he had on the fretboard, and the subtlety as well, because of the frame rate of the cameras at the time, you miss out on a lot of the technique he throws in because it's so quick, and the fact that he makes it look so easy. But when you listen to it, you can tell that there's a hell of a lot going on, even though he makes it look so easy, just like he's playing a standard pentatonic scale, when in fact he's putting together chromatic runs. He is putting blues scale in there at points, but he mixes together that jazz sound and blues sound so effortlessly. But thank you so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next one.